Hello, this is Eric Bolt from the National Weather Service in Oxnard, California. Here is the October update on El Nino and the latest predictions for the upcoming 2015 and 16 winter season across Southwest California. We have been in El Nino since last March, and it continues to strengthen. There is a greater than 95% chance of El Nino this winter, and forecasters favor a strong category. This is significant for Southern California. October's sea surface temperature anomaly continues to reflect warming across the tropical, central, and eastern Pacific Ocean. The latest ENSO 3.4 region, shown in the black box, is at 2.4 degrees Celsius and already reflecting a strong El Nino category. Temperatures remain above normal across much of the eastern and northern Pacific Ocean as well. The latest El Nino reading is in second place when compared to the two strongest El Ninos since 1950. The black line is where we are currently, just behind the 97-98 strong event, shown in blue, and just ahead of the 82-83 event in green. El Ninos typically peak in strength during the winter months and then weaken during the spring and summer. Computer models are mainly predicting that this winter's El Nino will be a strong event. The yellow line is the model average predicted for this winter season, and it peaks between 2 and 2.5 degrees Celsius, well above the 1.5 degree threshold for a strong El Nino event. All past strong El Ninos since measurements began in 1950 have resulted in above normal rainfall for downtown Los Angeles. This chart shows the past six strong events, along with the precipitation amounts during the 4 years prior to the El Nino season. Average rainfall for downtown is a little over 15 inches per year, and during strong El Ninos, rainfall has ranged roughly from 20 to over 30 inches. Looking across the entire state of California during the past six strong El Ninos since 1950 shows that precipitation has historically been above average across southern areas, while northern areas have been mixed. In these two strong events, much of central and northern California have been below average for the year, and this is significant as most of the large reservoirs are in this part of the state. Less precipitation in this region is a concern for drought relief and water supply for much of California. With El Nino predicted through the upcoming winter season, here is the precipitation outlook for the rainy season months of January through March. There is a greater than 60% chance of being wetter than normal across Southwest California. Normal annual rainfall ranges from about 15 to 25 inches across the area. The temperature outlook for the January through March timeframe calls for having slightly warmer than normal temperatures for the three-month period. A higher chance of above normal temperatures are depicted across Northern California. The conclusions of El Nino for this winter. El Nino does tilt the odds of above normal rainfall for Southwest California. The strength of this El Nino favors a strong event. One El Nino winter will not end the drought. And remember, we are still in our Santa Ana season, and until substantial rains occur, the potential for wildfires remains high. What are some of the potential winter impacts during a strong El Nino? We should be ready for numerous storms capable of multiple impacts, especially in the January through March timeframe. This would include high winds, high mountain snows, and flooding. During these storms, expect coastal erosion, large wave action, rip currents, and even waterspouts. Flooding concerns will be highest when we have several storms lined up in a row and the ground is no longer capable of absorbing rainfall and it's saturated. Debris flows near recent burn areas occur any year, and especially when we have intense downpours. What should you do to prepare for El Nino? Stay aware of weather predictions this winter. You can do that by following the National Weather Service on social media and the web, or listen to local media on TV, radio, or the internet. Prepare and take action now by improving your drainage or water issues you have around your property. Check your emergency kits. Think about flood insurance if that's been a problem in the past for water issues around your property. And also make sure you know how to be notified during these storm events. Thank you for listening to this presentation. Here is my contact information along with our website and social media channels.